Indonesia is a country with great potential in the industrial aspect. One of the industries that play an important role in Indonesia is the papermaking industry. Based on data from the Ministry of Industry, Republic Indonesia, this industry has contributed a gross domestic product of 0.67% in foreign exchange in 2021. The papermaking industry is inseparable from the use of water, be it condensation water, bleaching, vaporizing, cooking, material preparation, and filtering, so it causes the presence of foam. On the other hand, foam waste is often found on household waste. Most of the waste is detergent waste. Detergent contains surfactants which are not environmental friendly because it produces a lot of foam in short time, which has potential to pollute aquatic ecosystem.
Based on the previous problem, we conducted research to make COCTAF, an anti-foam agent which can quickly react to reduce foam, eco-friendly and avoidable because we use loosened material, specifically snail shells and cook oil, with the microwave heating research method.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello scientists.
My name is Alina Nandia Putri
and my name is Miesha Amira.
We are from Islamic State Senior High School of Tugudus.
In addition for our research background, we use cook oil because it has potential to produce metal ester in the process of transesterification as the main compound of antifoam. This is in our surrounding. Cook oil is seldom utilized.
And why we made it from snail shells? It because snail shells can be catalyst heterogen with calcium oxide content of 99.18%. According to Nung et al. On 2023, snail shells is a low-cost and natural animal that has a large potential surface area. It can be reacted in the process of transesterification to make antifoam.
Then, we choose the microwave heating method for our method to make our project to be more effective and making it fast. Formulation of the problem on our project are: what are the characteristics of the combination of snail shell and used cooking oil can be used as an anti-foam agent to reduce foaming, and how does the microwave heating method affect the manufacture of anti-foam agent?
Purpose from our research are knowing the characteristic of the combination of snail shells and used cooking oil which can be used as anti-foam agent to reduce foaming, and the effect of using microwave heating method in the manufacture of anti-foam agent.
There is 3 stages in this project. First stage is to make this antifoam agent. We had 6 steps before the snail shells and cook oil become an antifoam. The first step is catalyst calcium oxide.
The second step is neutralization of cook oil potential hydrogen.
The third step is transesterification reaction.
Fourth step is metal ester purification.
The last step is weighing the weight of metal ester and the glycerol.
The second stage is testing. We decide to test all the sample with 6 kinds of testing: X-ray fluorescence, present yield, viscosity, potential hydrogen, foam reduction percent, and foam reduction rate test.
This test is used for know about the oil content in snail shells. And from this test, we know snail shells is contain calcium oxide of 277.42 revolution per minute. This shows that snail shells has potential to be used as catalyst for the process of transesterification with the good quality.
Second is percent yield. We weighing all the sample and calculate all weight with a formula. The sample with the biggest percentage is with 20 power. Namely, for 0.6 gram calcium oxide is 86.8%, for 0.9 gram calcium oxide is 82.4%, and for the 1.2 gram calcium oxide is 77.3%. And the smallest is with microwave 30 power. Namely, for 0.6 gram calcium oxide is 48.6%, for 0.9 gram calcium oxide is 23.5%, and for 1.2 gram calcium oxide is 33%. From this data, we know the optimum yield percentage from the process of transesterification is use microwave with 20 power because it produces the highest yield. According to study 2018, too high power can cause excessive expansion and evaporation. So the contact between methanol and oil reaction cannot run perfectly. So the yield of metal ester is low. Process of transesterification without using microwave does not produce the metal ester. This is because agglomeration occurs from used cooking oil, calcium oxide powder, methanol, and sodium hydroxide. Trials, antifoam without using a microwave can produce a very large yield throughout the centrifugation process, where for 0.6 gram calcium oxide is 69.2%, for 0.9 gram calcium oxide is 84.3%, and for 1.2 gram calcium oxide is 78.6%. This is because the rotation in the centrifuge increases the frequency of collisions between particles, so the reaction gets faster. The centrifugation method without a microwave is not effective because the space inside the centrifuge is limited. Therefore, it's necessary to heat it using a microwave to prevent glycerol clumping.
The third is viscosity test. We use this test to know about the viscosity of the metal ester. We analyze the viscosity using NDT-XS viscometer. And from that, we know the metal ester with highest viscosity is without microwave step and was directly centrifuged with 1.2 gram calcium oxide, which was 0.445 P. Well, the lowest viscosity is antifoam with 30 power with 0.6 gram calcium oxide, which is 0.196 P. Based on the analysis before, we know the temperature inversion in the size of viscosity. According to Hamburg at 2002, the viscosity of the liquid will decrease with increasing temperature. The presence of calcium oxide catalyst affects the viscosity value of antifoam. The catalyst indicates the number of dissolved particles, so that the more dissolved particles, the higher the friction between the particles and the higher the viscosity value.
The fourth is potential hydrogen test. According to Tusana, 2009, most aquatic biota are sensitive with the chance of potential hydrogen. The ideal flow for life is between 7 until 8, and safe flow between 4 until 8. Lower potential hydrogen make most aquatic biota die. And from our research, we know the potential hydrogen of all variation antifoam is same, which was 5. That meaning the metal ester was acidic and safe for aquatic ecosystem. Where the potential hydrogen of glycerol is 11, that meaning this glycerol is alkaline. That is why the glycerol is not used as antifoam.
The fifth is foam reduction test. At 30 power, there was excessive expansion which caused the antifoam to overload. The overload process caused most of the content in the antifoam to disappear without knowing the concentration. So most likely, the 30 power data is biased data that is not guaranteed to be valid. From this research, we know the highest percentage was in the antifoam variation without microwave or 0.2 with calcium oxide of 0.6 gram. According to Lestari, 2018, a higher concentration of methanol will accelerate to foam reduction reaction. High heating will cause high evaporation of methanol, so that the higher the power used in the manufacture of antifoam, the less reduction in foam that will occur.
The sixth is foam decline test. In the explanation of the percentage of foam reduction, the 30 power antifoam variation data is biased, which is not necessarily valid. From this research, calculate the antifoam reduction speed with the appropriate data. It was found the antifoam which had the fastest foam reduction speed was the antifoam variation without microwave 0.2 with 0.6 gram calcium oxide, and the slowing down this foam was antifoam with a microwave power of 20 power with 1.2 gram calcium oxide. That's all the results of our research.
Thank you for your attention. And the last but not least,
COCTAF, effective,
eco-friendly,
and has affordable production costs.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.